which I live in here in Michigan, there is the legend, which goes back to ancient times, of the Mishipishu. And I've done videos on Mishipishu before. Mishipishu is an incredibly evil entity that supposedly lives beneath the waves of the Great Lakes, and with the swishing of its tail causes the violent storms that come up so often on the Great Lakes. Mishipishu is thought to be a giant panther that lives under the waves, and so you would think that representations of Mishipishu would be evident in effigies and things that would be found on a Native American site. In Alpena, on Thunder Bay, there are the Nagkazawan stones that were found. They go back, I believe, to the late woodland period. And one of those discs, stone discs, has a representation of Mishipishu on it. And some of the pictographs up in the up on Lake Superior have some pretty amazing pictographs of Mishipishu on them. Well, I feel that I found two effigies of Mishipishu. Now, you may disagree with me. That's fine. The ancient Native American artwork I'm finding in this area is very, what is the word? It's right there. Well, it's very abstract. Abstract is exactly what I was looking for. So you have to see not only with your eyes and your mind, but you have to see with your heart. Now, this piece, to me, looks like Mishipishu sitting on top of Lake Superior's, or one of the Great Lakes waves. This would be its head, one of its humps, another one of its humps, and then the tail part here is broken off. Now, there's another part to this stone, which is underneath it. So I'm thinking, you know, what? How would that fit in with this being an effigy? Well, if it's portable artwork to the Native American people, it could be set in the sand up to here to remind them, you know, to appease the spirit of Mishipishu. I think it's a really awesome effigy piece and an extremely rare piece. Now, that is not the only effigy, though, of Mishipishu that I believe that I've found there. This one is smaller, and it doesn't have the bottom piece on to set it up, but here we have the head and ear, or horns, of Mishipishu, and it comes up to a hump on the back and then down to, again, the tail is broken off from here. That may have been done purposely, for all I know. But these two pieces look to me very, very much like that evil entity that lives beneath the waves. Let me know what you think. Do you believe these are effigies? Do you believe they are paradelia? What do you think of them?